So in this example, we need to find the interval of convergence of this power series. Whenever we need to find the interval of convergence of power series, we firstly look at the power series composed of the absolute values of each term. So we look at these series. And to find the interval of convergence, we apply the ratio test. So we denote by AK the term in this series. So it is x minus 2 to the power k, the absolute value, and over k to the power 3. We can of course rewrite it as the absolute value of k minus, we can of course rewrite this as the absolute value of x minus 2 to the power k divided by k to the power 3. And now we will apply the ratio test. The ratio test tells us that we should take the number r, which is the limit when k goes to infinity, of ak plus 1 over ak. So in this case, we will have limit k goes to infinity, x minus 2 to the power k plus 1 divided by k plus 1 to the power 3, and we have here ak, so this x minus 2 in the bottom and k to the power 3 in the top of the fraction. So we will rewrite this limit in the following form. So this is the limit k goes to infinity, the absolute value of x minus 2 to the power k plus 1 over the absolute value of x minus 2 to the power k, and multiplied by the other fraction, which is k to the power 3 over k plus 1 to the power 3. Of course, we can write it as limit k goes to infinity, the absolute value of x minus 2 multiplied by the same fraction in here. So with respect to k, this term is just a constant. So we can put this out of the limit. So it will be x minus 2 multiplied by the limit k goes to infinity with the same fraction in here. Of course, when k goes to infinity, this limit is just 1. So we have that this equal to the absolute value of x minus 2. So we have that r in here equals to x minus 2. By the ratio test, the series, the original series in here will converge when r is less than 1. Rewriting this in terms of x, we will have that the absolute value of x minus 2 is less than 1. And now we can of course write it as x minus 2 less than 1, but greater than minus 1. And this is equivalent to x less than 3 and bigger than 1. So the ratio test tells us that for x in the interval 1 to 3, the series converge absolutely. So, we have found the interval of convergence of this power series. Now we need to discuss the behavior of this power series at the endpoints of this interval. We will take firstly the endpoint x equals 3. Substituting this value, we will have the series 1 to the power k over k to the power 3. 1 to the power k is of course just 1, so this is just the series 1 over k to the power 3. This series converge by the convergence test for P series. This one converges. We will take now another endpoint x equals to 1 and we will get this series minus 1 to the power k over k to the power 3. When we take the absolute values of each term, we will have the series, so the absolute value in here, and this just equal again to the series 1 over k to the power 3. Again, this one converge. Therefore, for both endpoints, this power series converges. And therefore, we can conclude that the series, the original series, converges for all x in the closed interval 1 to 3. That's all.